think shadows sucks in the advanced 3D renderer? Well, not anymore. Now, parallel and spotlights cast gorgeous quick rendering shadows, perfect for adding realism or even a touch of moody film noir drama to your scenes. And sure, point lights can't cast shadows yet, but hey, why point out the minor details? Let me walk you through how these shiny new features work and how you can squeeze every bit of awesomeness out of them. Quick heads up, at the time of this recording, you'll need the After Effects beta to follow along. As usual, you can grab it for free via the Creative Cloud app. So if you're ready, let me show you exactly how this works, and then we'll lightly touch on the geeky stuff. So I'll start with this scene. Notice that I have an environment light here, which is casting shadows. And if I'll preview it, the reason that we can't see the shadows yet is because we are using Draft 3D. So bear this in mind. The moment I'll switch it off, we can actually see how this works. And of course, we have some options for the layer transform if you want to change the way the shadows are being rendered. But this is what we have. It's very dark. And also notice it is a bit flickering. So notice over here at the side of the H, where this locomotive is casting shadows, you can see that there is some sort of a flickering issues that you just can't get rid of. So compare this to the same composition, but this time we are using three lights. So we have a point light, a parallel light, and spotlight. Now I'll first preview it so you can get a sense of how this looks, and much more smoother. Also notice that we do have shadows on the ground, and by ground I mean on this L letter from this air balloon. And it's also looking much more nicer, to my opinion at least. Now, the way you set it up, if I'll press Escape to switch to a different view, so this is custom view one, Escape is going to toggle between the last two views. And here you can see how I set this scene up. So I have a spotlight which is casting its light from above. And the new thing is that we can now turn on cast shadows. So you can do it either via the properties menu, or when you create the light, you can just turn it on over here. And by turn on, I mean turn on the cast shadows, of course. So you can control the shadow darkness as well as the shadow diffusion. The bigger this number is, the slower it will render. However, it is much faster than the environment light shadows, and you have more control. And this is not the only light that can cast shadows. You can also use a parallel light. So notice that this parallel light is over here in this scene. And I'll double click it again. And we can see that we can, of course, cast shadows as well as determine the shadow darkness, but we can't control the shadow diffusion. So this is for harsh, hard shadows. And I will show you an example in a moment how you can take advantage of this. But the point light that I have here, which is basically serving as a fill light right now, won't allow us to cast shadows, so maybe in the future. However, you must agree that this looks a little bit better, as well as, at least on my machine, 50% faster to render. Now, if you want to control the quality of the shadows, then you need to go to the renderer options, and over here, the renderer quality is going to affect the parallel and spotlight shadows. Everything underneath the shadows section over here is only going to affect the environment light. So if you don't have an environment light in this comp, then you don't need to worry about it. But you can mix and match, of course, between everything. And you can also change the way the shadow look. So I'm going to switch to another comp that I have here. And again, just so you can see it from a different angle, I'm going to use this pop-up menu. This is how I set those layers. So I have plenty of space here to cast shadows. I already have a point light in the scene. I'm going to escape out of this view, which is of course going to toggle me back to the regular camera view. And then I'll go to the layer menu, and under new, I'll create a new light. This time I'm going to use a parallel light. I'm going to set the color to pure white, and I'm going to make sure that cast shadows is enabled. I'll click OK. And now we have this point of interest, which is how you control basically the direction of a parallel light. And this is also going to affect the shadows themselves. So I can create something which looks really scary and moody, which works beautiful with this theme. Again, I'll press escape to toggle to a different view so you can get a sense of how this is looking from this perspective. Now, if you are here, I'm going to grab this shadow catcher, double tap the letter A, so AA in sequence, which is going to allow me to change the shadow color among our stuff. So I'll click on the color, and maybe I'm going to start by sampling a dark shade of purple from the scene, something along those lines. Maybe even brighter ones, just so you can get a sense of how the shadows are going to appear on the surface here. I'll press escape to come back to this view. And of course, I can still work with everything that I have previously. So if I want, I can use lights. For example, I have this point light to control the mood of the scene. By clicking on the light color, maybe I'll warm it up. I can change it to look a little bit more yellowish, maybe even more. It is free, so let's just give it a little bit more of a warm look. And basically, this is it. So I'll return back to the parallel light, and I can freely move the shadow on the floor. And all I need to do right now is maybe return to the orbit null, which basically controls the camera. I'll press R to show you the rotation and orientation properties. I'll click to create a keyframe for the Y rotation. Let's go all the way to the end. And then I'm just going to change the angle so we'll have something a little bit more interesting to look at. And this is also to show you that those shadows are quite interactive and very fast to render. Now I'll go to the beginning, I'll maximize this viewer, and I'll preview the comp. And while we are enjoying this view, let me walk you through some of the technical beats and the important details you need to know. You can use up to 8 spot or parallel lights and 1 environment shadow layer in a comp. So this is a total of 9 shadow sources. If you add more, then only the top 8 spot or parallel lights are going to cast shadows and other will just illuminate the object without casting any shadows. As I mentioned before, spot and parallel shadows render faster than environment shadows, and sharp shadows from the parallel light render even faster. The more you are diffusing the light, the softer the shadows get, but the slower the render will be. If you want, you can increase the quality slider in the advanced options. So let me just show you what it looks like, just as a reminder. So this guy over here, and a value between 24 to 64 typically suffice, but as you can see, I have mine set to 10. And the last thing that I'll tell you is that if you want to learn more about those new 3D tools, including shadows and other really exciting stuff, make sure to watch the video above my head. But first, before doing it, click on all the buttons underneath this one so we can stay in touch. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again in the next one.